Live from Vienna, Austria, it's theCUBE. Covering .NEXT Europe 2016. Brought to you by Nutanix. Here's your host, Stu Miniman.
And we're back. Happy to welcome to the program, first-time guest on the show, a partner of Nutanix from the Lenovo EMEA Group. It's Gianluca Delius-Posti, who is the Executive Director of the Data Center Group, as I said, from Lenovo. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.
So I think a lot of our audience will know, you know, Lenovo. Acquired a number of companies over the years, you know, two big ones from IBM on the PC and the server division, but you know, broad spectrum global company. Tell us, how long have you been there? What's your role? What's your background? What brought you to Lenovo?
Okay, so I've been in Lenovo since 3.5 years, more or less. I came from part of Lenovo, and I came from SystemX acquisition. Spent 25 years in the industries, starting from R&D in Alcatel-Teletra, originally in Italy. So designing ADSL cards, all these kind of things, very, very R&D. Then moved to AMD, so deploy a part of the go-to-market for AMD Opteron, so it was a big statement going 64-bit. Then I moved to Acer, Supermicro, and then basically joined Lenovo, building up organically the servers division, and then basically part of the SystemX acquisition.
All right, so my
responsibility is product solutions, go-to-market for EMEA, for Lenovo DCG, Data Center Group.
Okay, so your background and your position put you, you know, right and smack in the middle is where kind of compute and storage are all smashing together, no?
Yes. So architecture, CPU, and so on and so on. You know, that's clearly. The only difference that for Lenovo, we didn't, of course, part of SystemX acquisition, we didn't acquire the storage part, right? So still remain in IBM. For one specific reason as well, because Lenovo, not having storage legacy, can embrace much better the software-defined environment. Right, specifically hyperconvergence as evolution of software-defined is of course extremely important for us because can see us much better play in the storage market different than the others that have legacy in the storage. So that's why a key element of evolution of storage, not really as was in the past, but evolution in the software-defined storage and hyperconvergence.
Yeah, I had Dave Lincoln on, who's the general manager of the storage group back at the OpenStack show. And of course, since Lenovo doesn't own storage, it's through partnerships, a number of solutions, including the Nutanix OEM. Maybe if you could lay out for us, you know, where does Nutanix fit in that overall offering, and then we'll go into the Nutanix.
Absolutely. Yeah. So the Nutanix offer is basically going specifically in each segment, in one single segment inside Lenovo. Why? Because we distinguish between server classic product business and the storage business classic that is SAN and software-defined storage. Hyperconvergence as Nutanix being a mix of between the two things, servers and storage, we decided to have a specific group on top of hyperconvergence. So that's why it's distinguished between the two, because it needs to have a specific different direction and setup and sales organization taking care of basically these new technologies. In any case, is going quite fast in the market.
All right, so Gianluca, the OEM relationship's been going for a while. Is there anything new news as the partnership, any new announcements? How does 5.0 impact what you're doing?
Going to the secret sauce. So,
yeah.
No, the first of all, we are extremely happy about the partnership. We see, of course, Nutanix in EMEA, specifically moving forward. Typically, not easy for an American startup, relative startup now for Nutanix, but you know, EMEA market is very complex. You know, different languages, different country, different cultures, and for startups coming from US, you know, exploring and be successful in EMEA is not easy. I think Lenovo is helping as well Nutanix, and that's why Lenovo embracing Nutanix, because our DNA in EMEA market is basically presence in each of the country. And as well as we are indirect business compared to direct business. So it's helping us also for Nutanix to build up more relationship with the system partners and having basically much better footprint in overall the country. In terms of evolution of our products, surely when we embrace Nutanix, we deploy a specific roadmap, all HX family, including Express Sellers. So I think we see each other really brothers, even more, let's say, twins. That's basically something that make the two companies successful in the EMEA market. So.
Okay. I've heard from Dell that they're also having success here in EMEA. Do you run up, you know, how many times are you going in with customers and saying, oh, I'm choosing between, you know, native Nutanix, Lenovo, Dell, or is it still mostly kind of the legacy, if you will, versus Nutanix?
Yes, in fact, you know, that's one of key point. Of course, we embrace Nutanix, partnership with Nutanix after Dell EMC, right? That's fair to say. But we have seen that there are a lot of opportunity also for our existing Lenovo customers, and also because those customers, they are very loyal to Lenovo for certain reasons. Quality, reliability, service, supply chain, and so on and so on. So, yeah, we have seen also Nutanix and we see Dell EMC, but I think, you know, the good important thing is that we are embracing hyperconvergence in the proper way. And as I said, compared to Dell EMC, now even better, we have nothing to protect. Dell EMC, they have to protect their storage business, why we don't have, we don't need to do, right? So basically, we are more enthusiastic, proactive in their business than compared to the others.
Totally.
So we can win.
Yeah. Is there any metrics you could share as to adoption of the Nutanix with Lenovo? Either, you know, number of units, percentage revenue growth, or even just kind of growth in Europe versus worldwide?
I think that I can give you an idea how we are investing on Nutanix. Since we enable Nutanix in portfolio, Lenovo actually placed quite a number of headcounts per country overall Europe. So it means that investment that Lenovo has done in having salespeople focused in hyperconvergence, so means Nutanix, is quite substantial, you know, in number of people per country. So it means that we are in a good shape to make the right things, let me say.
All right, we can't talk specific numbers. Tell me about the customers.
Let me say, in 20, 30 people moving in that direction, so let me say. That's
okay.
Good. Specialized, so it means not specifically only broader, but specialized in hyperconvergence.
Sure. What are you hearing from customers? You know, what brings the Lenovo Nutanix solution to the table? What's exciting customers?
The beauty when we discuss the customer, that they want to have an alternative of the classic storage. They want to have an alternative of how they can deploy much better, flexible and agile their solutions. And means that they want to understand also how they can do in a different way, as I say. When we talk about Nutanix and Lenovo, they see two key elements, reliability, solid OEM in servers, with history behind, and as well as flexibility of Nutanix software. And then basically this is a good combination. So we are able to give to the customer, specifically large enterprise customer, those two key ingredients between good reliability of the products and flexibility of the hyperconvergence. So that's for me the two key elements that helping us to win. So.
Okay, I was wondering if you could give me a little color. You know, when we went to the U.S. conference, you know, the term hyperconvergence, a lot of people, they kind of understand and they hear about it, but, you know, the line I'd say is I've never talked to a CIO that said, I've got a hyperconvergence problem. Cloud is something that we're all understanding, grappling with. What's the typical enterprise, you know, customer in Europe? What's their mindset on kind of these buzzwords? What's important to them? You know, digital transformation seems to be a global discussion, but as it turns to kind of infrastructure, you know, what's driving their discussion? You know, where does it sit in priorities?
Yeah. So that's a good question. So if you see end customers at the level, means global accounts, 1,000 employee up, surely they are looking carefully hyperconvergency, they're looking also carefully cloud. The big dilemma right now is public versus hybrid, people are going hybrid, right? And of course hyperconvergency is a first step to go basically in a considering cloud software stacks, right? And the fact that Nutanix is having clear roadmap in how they go from and, you know, the first hyperconverged setup and going to cloud software stacks, surely is the right process to give to the enterprise customer such level of transition and roadmap, right? Of course, end users or enterprise customers specifically, they need to understand how to move from classic way to do things, having operation management, server, storage, networking, to go in a different environment that see in one single box all the three items together, potentially. So the way that they need to change is not really how to get flexibility of the hardware, but how to manage this new technology, and then specifically on the cloud. In any case, they are obliged to change the way they are managing all these kind of things, because they need to go to the cloud, hybrid or public, that's up to them. But their way to take care of products in their IT, in their data center, is surely different than what they are doing today. So that's basically what we see.
Yeah. What is the customer mindset? You know, the discussion for so long is, you know, enterprise IT is very slow to change. Yeah. They don't want to do new stuff. It feels like we're starting to get, you know, people trying things a little sooner. But I want, you know, what do your customers tell you?
Let me say, there are of course customers that, you know, they are still a little bit want to understand, but still reluctant in the way they are approaching. And they need a little bit more time in understanding the technology. They see the benefit, but I think, as I say, they are still not able to understand how they can manage compared to their classic way to take care of their data center. They also other customer, specifically those that are building up new branch offices from scratch. Basically, they see that this is the key value to basically deploy their IT infrastructure, totally different than what has been done before, right? So we have two different ways of customers. Those that are a little bit more reluctant, but in any case, moving forward in understanding POC and then adoption. And those in reality, they are a little bit smaller, but maybe with less legacy in the classic IT, they are really looking to get, you know, enthusiastic and get adoption quite fast. That's why we see two different ways, a little bit more time and fast embracing. That's why I think Nutanix has been able to go fast in those customers that were more ready to take new technology hyperconvergency in their data center.
So Gene, look, what's exciting you in the marketplace today? What kind of gets you geared up and excited about what's happening?
Personally, let me say, Lenovo, and personally, I think that is the evolution in Europe about public cloud and hybrid cloud is one of the things that is most fascinating. And then the IoT side, because if you see the IoT, it looks like it could be purely public environment. In reality, it's not.
By the way, Wikibon, we've looked at this extensively, and just the physics of data, edge computing will be critically important. You're a compute guy, you understand.
Exactly.
If all the data is being created at the edge, just the physics of moving all the data just isn't going to work. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And then also there is the item that European Commission set up for the data protection, right? That is an item that in Europe is getting a little bit different in North America. So it means that those that are doing public cloud, they are in any case forced to have data center locally in the countries. But also how they're moving, enterprise company, they're moving in hybrid is a part that, you know, they have to do it for feeling comfortable in whether application load, identity, confidentiality, all these kind of things. But I see that sooner or later, when they get more comfortable in their cloud environment, in private cloud, they can move potentially much faster in the public too. So that is what is fascinating. And then the other side is the IoT environment, because still demanding as a digital transformation, a lot of computational power and as well as offering the public cloud. That is also, I think we are in a kind of age that is we're going to see in the next 5-6 years really big dynamics in the IT industry. So.
Yeah, great, absolutely. There's no shortage of new things to get everybody excited for. All right. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll
Thanks
be back
you.
With lots more coverage here from the Nutanix.next conference in Vienna, Austria. You're watching theCUBE.